Hi students, today we have a lecture on concrete technology. Concrete technology basically deals with concrete. Concrete is a mixture of fine aggregate, coarse aggregate and water in respective ratios, and once we mix all this it turns into concrete. Now concrete in the initial stages it is in the form of wet concrete, and after in due course of time it gets solidified and then it is called as solid concrete. So now in this lecture we will be seeing the tests on wet concrete and as well as solid concrete. Now moving on to the tests on wet concrete, we have for finding out the water cement ratio, and then we have a tests on workability, which are slump test, compaction factor test, VB consistometer test and Kelly-Ball test. As far as water cement ratio is concerned, in this test we will be finding out what is the optimum water that is required for giving the maximum strength. So generally it is around 0.4 to 0.5. The water cement ratio is generally around 0.4 to 0.5. Because as the water content is increasing, the strength of concrete will be initially increasing, and then after it reaching the maximum value at an optimum water content, the strength of the concrete will be decreasing gradually. So from the experiments it has been determined that the water cement ratio will be optimum at 0.4 to 0.5, which is based on Duff-Abrams law. And so this is about water cement ratio. Next we are moving on to the workability. Workability is actually the ease with which one can work with concrete. It is an important property of concrete. For the concrete can be transported, placed and compacted, everything is decided by the term workability. So there is an every need to find out what is the workability of concrete. So various tests have been conducted to find out the workability. As you can see in the slide, workability is associated with the following four concepts. For number one is ease of flow, prevention of segregation, prevention of harshness and prevention of bleeding. So these four parameters should not be associated with workability. And basing on these four characteristics, various tests have been framed, and these tests we will be seeing in the next coming slides. So from this slide what we understand is workability is the ease with which one can work with concrete. That means you have to mix, transport and place the compacted concrete. So how easy it is to handle concrete, that is what the workability parameter will be telling you. So there are various tests considering the four concepts. So number one you have slump test, compaction factor test, flow test, Kelly-Ball tests and VB consistometer test. So first we will be moving on with the slump test. So slump test, it generally consists of a conical frustum, and the wet concrete is being placed in the conical frustum, and once the conical frustum is removed, the concrete will start slipping down, and basing upon the difference in the heights of the initial concrete and the final concrete, the slump test will tell you about the workability. So it is a method to determine the consistency of concrete in which the stiffness of the concrete mix should be matched to the requirement for the finished product. So it is the principle behind it is the measure of behavior of compacted inverted cone of concrete under the action of gravity. So basically when the concrete is confined in this inverted cone, it will be stable. Once the confinement in the form of the inverted cone is removed, the concrete will slowly drop down. So the initial height when it was confined with the inverted cone, and then when it is removed, the height differences will give the values of slumps. So there are various different kinds of slumps based upon the shape of the slump, which we'll be seeing in the further slides. So next, moving on, for the conduction of slump cone test, you have the apparatus which consists of a slump cone, 300 mm height, and the base must be of 200 mm in dia, and it has a small opening at the top of 100 mm. Bottom the opening is 200 mm, at the top it is 100 mm, the height is 300 mm. As you can see, it is in the shape of a conical frustum. And then you have a tamping rod which has to be used for properly compacting the concrete. Tamping rod size, you have 16 mm diameter and 60 centimeters length, and again you need to have a scale for measuring the height difference. So these are the apparatus. Now the procedure, the base is placed on the smooth surface and the concrete is placed in three layers for whose the workability has to be tested, and each layer must be tampered with the tamping rod 25 times. The tamping rod image is already given in the apparatus slide. You can go through that. And after the top layer has been tamped, the concrete, after it is completely tamped up to the top, the concrete, excess concrete at the top of the cone is struck off with a trowel or a tamping rod. Tamping rod, horizontally you can place it and you can remove the excess concrete above the cone, conical frustum. And then the mold is removed, lifting slowly. You have to slowly lift the inverted cone carefully in a vertical direction. This allows the concrete to slide down. The difference in level between the height of the mold and that of the highest point of the subsided concrete is measured. The difference in height in mm is taken as the slump of the concrete. Initially, when the concrete is under confinement with the mold, and then once the mold has been lifted up slowly, the concrete will start falling down as there is no confinement surrounding it. So the concrete will slowly fall down. Now the height difference between the initial when the mold is placed and when the mold is removed, the height difference is taken, and with that values you can decide what kind of a slump is it. Now the slump is consisting of three types: the collapsed slump, shear slump, and true slump. True slump is generally the apex point will be at the center and the corners will be falling down evenly. For in case of a shear slump, one side will be falling down completely, but the other side it will be stiff enough before and after removal of the mold. And the other one is the collapsed slump. Collapsed slump, it almost like it will be touching the ground, it will be touching the base, because the height difference will be much more compared to the other two one. So these are the three types of slumps: collapsed slump, shear slump, and true slumps. Now next, moving on to the compaction factor test. It is also one kind of a test which will be telling about workability of concrete. Compaction factor test, it is developed at the Road Research Laboratory, UK. It is generally used for laboratory purpose. For the field purpose, it is preferred to use slump test. Compaction factor test is generally used for the laboratory purposes. It generally consists of three buckets placed one above the other, the wet concrete is being placed in the topmost bucket, and then the bottommost, and the concrete will be falling down from the buckets one after the other, and the concrete gets compacted because of gravity. And then the values are being taken by comparing these two values of concrete. So moving on to the procedure, we have the apparatus must be cleaned before the test, and the weight of the bottommost cylinder must be taken up to 10 grams. And then you have to fill the uppermost bucket or the upper hopper with the concrete whose workability has to be tested. Immediately you have to open the trap door. You have a trap door fitted to the bottom of the bucket. The trap door must be opened so that the concrete will fall down into the next bucket immediately. And then after, the concrete will fall down into the middlemost bucket, and again the trap door of the middlemost bucket must be removed, and then it finally falls down into the bottommost bucket. And then in the process of falling down from one after the other, the concrete will get compacted partially. So this, the weight of the bottommost bucket is then taken, which is filled with concrete, and then you have to subtract the empty weight of the bucket in order to get the weight of the concrete alone. Now the fresh concrete is placed in the bottommost bucket, tamped properly. That means it is compacted properly, and then in different layers, and then the weight of the properly compacted concrete is also taken. Now you have two weights. One weight is the weight of the partially compacted one, and then you have the weight of the fully compacted concrete. The partially compacted concrete is nothing but the weight of the concrete which has fallen from the buckets consequently. whereas the fully compacted concrete is nothing but the concrete which is placed manually in the bottommost bucket and then tamped gradually with the number of tampings, 25. So there you have two weights. Now the comparison of two weights will give you the compaction factor. So you have furthermore procedure for this, which has been already discussed now. So weight of the, you can see the compacting factor value is given by weight of partially compacted by weight of fully compacted concrete. Now this the values have been given for very low, for slump it is 0 to 25, for in case of compaction factor it is 0.78. When for a low workability it is 25 to 50, compaction factor value is 0.85. For medium workability the slump value is 25 to 100 and the compaction factor value is 0.92. For high workability it is around 100 to 175 and for compaction factor it is, in terms of compaction factor, it is 0.95. For generally reinforced concrete structures we consider high values in terms of slump cone and the compaction factor. And then moving on to the flow test. The flow test consists of a flow table which is in the shape of a rectangle, horizontal rectangle, a flow table. And then it also consists of a conical bucket and also a tamping rod. This test is generally decides as the flow of the concrete when it is placed horizontally. The flow test will be giving the value of workability in terms of diameter of the concrete which has been spread after removal of the flow bucket. Now moving on, if the consistency is not correct, the concrete will not have the desired qualities once it has set. That means if you does not test the workability, it will not give you the desired values of strength. The concrete will not give you the desired values of strength which is supposed to give you. So workability plays a very major role in finding out the strength of the concrete. So flow test equipment consists of a flow table with a grip and a hinge 70 centimeters by centimeters, and it contains Abraham's cone which is open at the top, which is nothing but the bucket which is open at the top and at the bottom, 30 centimeters high, 17 centimeters diameter at the top and 25 centimeters at the bottom. It is similar like the slump bucket in the shape of a frustum of a cone, and you have water bucket and broom for spreading the concrete along the flow table, and you have a tamping rod which is of 60 centimeters high, and you again you have the scale for measuring the radius of the spread concrete. The test is conducted by, firstly you have to wet the flow table, and then the cone is placed on the flow table and then filled with fresh concrete in two layers. Each layer is 25 times tamped by the tamping rod. Now once the cone is lifted, the concrete will flow down. The flow table is then lifted up several centimeters so that the concrete will drop down a little further and the concrete will also flow a little further. So after this, the diameter of the concrete is measured in the six different ways, taking the average of all the six directions. The radius measured in the six directions, average of the radius measured, radius or diameter measured in the six directions. This value will be the flow table value. And the next test is the Kelly-Ball test. It is one of the important tests because this test gives you the value of workability after the concrete getting solidified. So this is the unique feature of a Kelly-Ball test. It can give you the workability of a concrete which is not wet. So another method used in the field and laboratory to measure the consist of concrete is the ball penetration test, which is known as the Kelly-Ball test. It is performed by measuring the penetration in inches. The ball will penetrate into the concrete, the solidified concrete of a 6-inch diameter steel cylinder with a hemispherically shaped bottom weighing 30 lbs. The weight of the cylinder is ball is 30 lbs. The advantages of Kelly-Ball test is the ball penetration test can be performed on the concrete in a hopper, buggy, wheelbarrow or other suitable containers. Anywhere you can perform this test. And another advantage of this method is it is a simplicity and rapidly with which the consistency of the concrete can be determined. The procedure is not tedious. It is one simple way by placing the Kelly-Ball forcefully, it will give you the penetration. The penetration is measured in inches. And with these values, you can figure out the workability of concrete. It is also not dependent on a procedure for filling and rotting a container like the slump test. There is no requirement of tamping, and neither there is no scale and used for measuring. The ball itself contains gradation so that you can measure the value straight away from the ball. So this is about Kelly ball test. And then next you have the VB consistometer test. VB consistometer test is also an important test which is used for measuring the workability. It gives you the workability in terms of time. It is actually the time taken for the conically shaped concrete to level down. The concrete is placed in the shape of a conical frustum, as in the case you have seen in slump cone test and a floatable test. The same kind of a conical frustum is placed, and the conical shaped concrete is being shaked by means of a shaker, and then this conical shaped concrete will settle down. It will get leveled down into the shape of a cylinder. So the time taken by this conical shaped concrete to become a cylindrical shape, the time required will give you the workability of the concrete again. So as you can see, it is based on measuring the time, called VB time. It is the time required to transfer the shape of a concrete mix from a frustum of a cone to a cylinder. So the change in shape is brought by giving vibrations. These vibrations are given by the VB consistometer. The more VB time needed, the less workable the mix is. That means the time it is taking more time to get transferred into the form of a conical frustum to a cylinder. That means the concrete is solid. When the concrete is being solid, that means the water content is much more less. So it is so heavy, it will be very heavy to work on it, and it is not so easy to work on it. That is why if the time taken in the VB test is more, that means the workability is less. This method is very useful for staff mixes, for stiff mixes. And if you see the apparatus, cylindrical container with diameter 240 mm, height 200 mm, mould, the same mould used in the slump test can be used. You can see the same mould placed in the figure, and a transparent horizontal disc attached to a rod which slides vertically. You can see the vibrating table. This table helps in falling the shape of the frustum of the cone into a cylinder. The vibrating table dimensions are around 380 by 260 mm, supported by four rubber shock absorbers, and you have a tapping rod and a stopwatch. Stopwatch is to figure out, to record the time taken for the transfer of shape from frustum of a cone to a cylinder. And then you have a procedure. I just told about the procedure. Again, you can see the procedure. Slump test, as described earlier, is performed placing the slump cone inside the sheet metal cylinder part of the consistometer. So what you can understand from this is, previously the slump test we have done it on a plain ground, on a smooth ground. Now the same slump is being placed inside the sheet metal cylinder of the consistometer. Now the glass disc attached to the swivel arm is turned and placed on the top of the concrete in the pot. The electrical vibrator is then switched on, and now this vibrator will allow the concrete which is in the shape of the frustum of a cone to slowly fall down into the form of a cylinder because of the vibration. So the time required to fall into the shape is then recorded. The time required for the shape of concrete to change from slump cone shape to cylindrical shape in seconds is known as the VB degree. This is very suitable for very dry concrete whose slump value cannot be measured by slump test. But the vibration is too vigorous for concrete with slump greater than about 50 mm. If the slump is greater than 50 mm, what happens is it cannot withstand the vibration. So the test fails if VB time is less than 5 seconds. If the time is coming around 5 seconds, less than 5 seconds, that means that it has failed the VB test. The concrete has failed the VB test. Okay, this is about workability of concrete. We shall meet in the next lecture. Thank you.